God has raised up Jesus, whom ye slew and hanged on a tree. Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, to give repentance to Israel and the forgiveness of sins.
Repentance to Israel.
The question you then got to ask, who are these people in Israel? What are known as the lost tribes? So-called Latino to the Native American Indians, we are the people. We the reason. The reason we went into slavery is because we disobeyed the commandments of our God. We eat pork, you know, we other things.
Shellfish.
So as a punishment, the Lord put us in slavery. He put us under the subjection of who He calls the heathen. The white man is included up. That's why we went through all that, man. Because we disobeyed our father. But even then, we still had the spirit to have faith and pray towards the Lord. That's because we really, as people, we just lost our ways, and we coming back to it. Now we know that we're the Israelites. Now we know why we went into slavery. Now we know how we got in this predicament, and now we know how to get out of it. It's through His Lord and Savior. The Bible says Jesus, but that's not true. He sure has the same name as Joshua. And the Old Testament was written in Hebrew. And how do you pronounce Joshua in the Hebrew is Yahweh Shah. It's a Hebrew name, which means He is the same and He is the living. He's only sent to save a sect of the nation of Israel, not the whole world.
I got Psalms 147, verses 19 through 20. He showeth His word unto Jacob, His statutes and His judgments unto Israel. He had not dealt so with any nation. And as for His judgments, they have not known them. Praise ye the Lord.
In Israel, He made Himself known to not the whole world. Yes.
You familiar with the Apostle Paul? Okay. So you know about the book of Romans, right? It's not written to the Romans. It's written to the Israelites. So this is Romans 11, starting at verse 1. And it reads, I say then, has God cast away His people? That's the question of Paul's grace, right? God forbid. No. Okay? For I also am an Israelite of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin. You see? Benjamin is right on that sign right there, second one. You see? I'll go on to the second verse. The Most High have not cast away His people, which He foreknew, knew us from old times. What ye not what the scriptures of Elias, which is our Lord, who make it intercession to the Most High against them. So he goes on and gives a little bit of a history, but that tells you Romans 11 and 1, he recognized himself. And that's who we are. We're not Negroes, we're not coarse monkeys, we're not wetbacks, beaners. Okay, we're the Israelites. So, there you go. Go ahead, brother.
It's like you're Israelite. Y'all are Israelite boys. Well, they were Israelites, but, you know, Sarah, Rachel, Leah, all them, they were all so-called black men. Jacob was a so-called black man. The pictures and the truth goes a long way. This is who we are. That's why we're so special.
So this is out of the book of Apocrypha, which the Roman Catholic Church is saying is not casual canon. This is the book of Baruch, chapter 4, and verse 6. And the reason it says, ye were sold to the nation, not for your destruction, but because you moved God to wrath, and ye were delivered unto the enemies. Now, this is going into why we are in this predicament, because we moved the Lord into anger. Okay, the Lord told us not to go into these other guys, to follow the heathen nations, eating certain things and stuff like that. Hey, we made the Lord very angry. Just like you got kids, your kids don't do what you ask. If your kids don't do what you ask them to do, you'll end up punishing. So that's basically what the Lord did with us. He punished us and stuff like that to get it together and stuff. Verse 7, for ye provoked Him that made you, by sacrificing to devils as of sacrificing to other idols. The Lord doesn't like that because He's a jealous power. And it says that not to God. ye have forgotten the everlasting God that brought you up, and ye have grieved Jerusalem that nourished you. So, hey, the reason why we're predicting is because we made the Lord angry. But, hey, soon we're going to be risen back up again. That's a good nation.
Huh?
Hey, just in some process.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, and I'll start at verse 47, sorry. Because thou servest not the Lord thy power with joyfulness and with gladness of heart for the abundance of all things, therefore shalt thou serve thine enemy, which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things, and he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck, until he have destroyed thee.
Yoke of iron upon our neck until he have destroyed thee. That's a prophecy that happened to him. It happened to us. They literally put the yoke of iron on our neck. And while we was in slavery, they forbid us to read the scriptures. Why? Because we would read, put two and two together. Hey man, hold on, that's us. Let's pray to our Lord.
Find out the truth.
Exactly. So, appreciate you stopping by.
Thank you.
Want you to know.
We do it the same way.
Yeah, just know you do it this way.
We are.
Lord, his name is Yahweh Shai.
Thank you all.
Okay, yes ma'am. Yes ma'am.
Appreciate it with y'all.
Shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word, be in season, be instant, in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, But after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth, but shall be turned to fables. But watch thou in all things. Endure affliction, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry.
So, ultimately, you're supposed to do the work of an evangelist. And I like that word. Did you look that up?
Yeah, I got it.
Go ahead.
Okay, evangelist. A person who seeks to convert others to the Christian faith, especially by public preaching.
Like I told them, the Lord did it, that's why we do it. Now, you can type the new videos or whatever that helps the body, things like that, that's good too, right? Because we read, back to verse 3.
Verse 3, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears.
Right, because we live in a generation full of wicked, adulterous, what the Lord calls this adulterous, sinful generation. And if it's one thing, these people seek validation for their actions. They want to walk around feeling clean for what they doing, knowing that it's wicked. So naturally, they flock themselves to the same people who basically subscribe to the same shit they do. Whether it's on the internet or what. That's why they'll make these videos, like women will make videos about their body count and say, like, I shouldn't be. But why are you making a video? Because you're trying to get other women to come to you and listen to you and feel good about the same damn thing. We can niggas doing the same shit. So what you should do, knowing you got the truth, you're supposed to just bring that out.
Look at what the scripture says. What the scripture says, the shameless woman shall be better than the world. Now here it is, she knows she's doing something wrong. Like you said, she need validation. She needs somebody to tell her that it's okay. And who's the main person that does that? He shall be the so-called man. Alright, he give these women a platform, and he give you like little medicines for the diseases that you take, diseases that you catch, for being a slut, set up abortion clinics, so you don't have to have accountability for your actions, okay? So yeah, this is where that we live here. You know, this is paradise to the majority of our women. You know, they can sleep with whoever they want. Pretty much worship as a god here. All right, but all that's about to come to an end.
That's right.
Right, and I just looked up the words on the Greek condition ears. And desiring of hearing something pleasant. So you got these people who keep to themselves, people who say things designed or something pleasant. And you know the scripture says what? That the world loves lies. So everybody loves lies. But no one likes the truth. You're the party who ran on that parade. They want to just indulge in this folly. And you come in and you drop some knowledge and they basically cash you out. But you know what? It's supposed to be like that. Teaching the word, that's the best thing you can do for these people. I hate the fact that lies are on the forefront. That's why the scripture says folly sin great things. I hate to see that these motherfucking liars get away with so much. Right? And they try to suppress the truth. It's like, right. No, the truth gotta come out, man. You gotta keep coming out.
Yeah, because the right hand gonna always be stronger than the left. Okay, like the orthodox boxing stance, you got the left in front, the jab, you come to the right, you know, like that's the knockout hand. Alright? Yeah, hey, this place is wicked. Hey, but the lies can only go for so long. And the truth is just gonna bitch just overtake it. Okay, because lies don't have a foundation. Alright?
And just knowing, even when I came to the truth, just knowing that if it's one thing that the devil wishes, which is Esau evil, he wishes, if it's one thing he would wish, like vocab, he would wish that we would just pack it up and just go AWOL. Never heard of this. Knowing that, I'm gonna do the exact opposite just because it pisses you off. whatever you want me to do is exactly what you should be doing. The devil, at the very least, wants you to just be silent and comply, right? Just be silent. He just wants a society full of dumb idiots that don't think, that don't question, that don't ask. So at the very least, you should do the opposite. You should ask. Right. You should inquire. Right. You should bring it up. Bring it up, right? And if it's, if that's something you don't want to do, then that's something you don't need to be involved with. Not need to be involved.
Right, I say so. And when you think about it, everything in this place is fake. The holidays is fake. There ain't no fat guy named Santa Claus coming down your chimney giving you presents and all that. There is no Thanksgiving. It was Thanksgiving. Thanks slaughter. Alright? Halloween goes back to the thing like witchcraft. Wasn't it the Salem Witch Trials? Yeah.
Commemorating the name on their behalf.
Like, it's not even about children. Okay? It's about basically becoming like a whole new creature. Right? You get to be somebody else. And that's why these women, Halloween, they get the sluttiest outfits. You know, a bloody nurse, a sexy devil, a cat, leopard, all that. That's another reason to dress slutty.
I got a precept if you don't mind. This is Isaiah 30, verse 9 through 13. That this is a rebellious people, lying children, that will not hear the law of the Yahweh, which say to the seers, see not, and to the prophets, prophesy not unto us right things, speak to us smooth things, prophesy deceits. Get you out of the way, turn aside out of your path, cause the Holy One of Israel to cease from before us. Wherefore, thus said the Holy One of Israel, because ye despise this word, and trust in oppression and pervertedness, and stay thereon, therefore this iniquity shall be to you as a breach ready to fall, swelling in a high wall, whose breaking cometh suddenly and at an instant.
Alright, so you want to keep to yourself lies that you think you're surrounding yourself in a house of brick, not really a house of clay, not even clay, hay. That all it takes is the right wind, strong wind, and get the shit out of here. You know, so you basically, like Scripture says, made lies your refuge. It's like money. But that's what happens.
God, I have something about bed into the marriage. Matthew, 22nd chapter, verse 9. It says, Yahweh shall answer and speak unto them again by parables, and said, the kingdom of
St. Luke chapter 4, verse 16, it reads, and he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day, and stood up for it to read. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. When he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written. Back, Luke 4:16. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up for it to read.
Right, that was a custom back then. The Sabbath, Jake could get together, like church, get together, and hear the word of the Lord. That's really the best thing you can do. So it's that way, he stood up.
Verse 17, and it was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. When he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written.
Right, so he stood up took the book, read. He was doing the work of what he did. He was out and about teaching. Right? That's what he did. That's what we're doing. But for some reason, it's so strange when they look upon the street preachers. Oh, that's strange. How's it strange? That's what our people did back then. Right. That's literally what the Lord did. You got these Christians that look upon us and say, that's strange. Wait. You know so much about the Lord, you know that was his method. He spoke from a boat to speak from people, thousands of people, from a boat.
Hey, what do you say about this church? It's like a whorehouse. His spirit ain't dealing with this. So, the Lord looking at you for it. Yeah. Are you thinking that his man pointing out here on the street, he was looking at you for it? What the hell wrong with these young guys? Didn't I say in the word that? But, you know, they not believing their records, man. The people choose what they want to, you know, believe like scriptures.
You know, the same people that turn around and say that we cherry pick and speak the scriptures.
Yeah, this is what you don't mind. This is Psalms 119. Okay, this is Psalms 119, starting at the 18th verse through the 19th verse. It says, open thou my eyes, that I may behold wondrous things out of the law. I am a stranger in the earth. Hide not thy commandments from me.
Matthew 5 on your list. All right, this is Matthew 5, and I'll jump in at verse 14, and it reads, ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick. And it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. So that's why we come out here in the street. You know, if the Lord has given you the wisdom and understanding of this word, then we come out here on the street and we show our faith by preaching this word.
That's right. We're supposed to let our light shine forth. So if someone comes in fire, you break it down to them. Here it is, the truth. And you know, like the brother said, yeah, having an understanding of scripture, you know more than these so-called doctors. You know more than Dr. Ward Johnson. Because he said, I'm a psychologist and all that. But you don't even understand, well, he was on that thing, the tranny. The question was, is black men under attack? Yeah, I believe so. If somebody with some knowledge would say, of course, if you read the scripture, you say that the scriptures tell you that all the other nations are gathered against us. The scriptures tell you, break down the parable of the first blind and strong man. You go to Eve and the serpent and you say that. See, you bring them out and you shut the whole conversation down. Versus, let's go back to the 70s. Well, then we'll go back to the 80s. I mean, all that's factual. You bring out the scripture, then it shut up. Yeah, because according to the scripture, it's just Satan. It's like, it's even the serpent being brought back again. And then you go into the scripture, and then you break down the parable by the strong. Man, you shut that shit down. That's simple. But they ain't got it. But he's a doctor. He makes six figures. But he don't understand the simple concept, because he believes that without the black man and the black woman together, yeah, we both make these choices. That's what you're wrong. See, if you do the scripture, you understand we don't need our black man. Literally just push her out of, see you later, don't need you. See, you don't even understand that. Then you understand more of your version of working about yourself. You got people that's, the teachers have on the chair, you got people that are, well, I listen to that group when he speak the truth about the black man. Well, he doesn't really know how to teach healing to our people. If we taught healing to our people, we would first focus on the men. Focus on the men, and them in control. That's how they go follow, they gonna see you, because women just follow this man. They gonna see you leading, and then they gonna follow. But you gotta really put the focus on this man from.
Right. They respect power. Okay? Like brothers should be focused on like self-improvement. Instead of focusing on trying to get bucks. You know? Which we know that that's basically like a military tactic that you saw so-called white man did to our men. It's to sexually deprive us from our women. Okay?
Now, when Jake is only thinking about women,
he's not really thinking straight. You know, make poor decisions. And,
this is John, the 21st chapter, verse 15. You got to say this. John, the 21st chapter, verse 15 through 17. The reason it says, so when they had dined, Yahweh saith unto Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than these? He saith unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He saith unto him, feed my lambs. He said to him again the second time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? He said unto him, yea, Lord, that thou knowest that I love thee. How he said unto him, feed my sheep. And he said unto him the third time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, lovest thou me? And he said unto him, Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee. Thou shalt say unto him, feed my sheep.
So the Lord
that
is basically what he says to you. You know, you have opportunity to counsel. Brother, I'll go over here. The Lord is going to spread and pass it around. Really, see it, really get it. So, yeah, you may have some people out there who are board directors of schools. They doing all this to help their people. You got some people who, like I said, try to help people on the show. You know, they like, I just like help people, nurses, doctors. They just say like, yeah, I got a passion for helping people out there. That's cool. But guess what? You can take joy in knowing that you also are helping your people. You're doing it the best way possible. You're doing it the best way possible. Because telling someone the truth will go much farther than giving them a line which they're going to end up destroying at this point. Or taking them out of the and destroying themselves and back on this people. So this is it, man. This is the best thing you can do.
So back in Luke, the fourth chapter, and we're in verse 17 back again. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. When he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of the sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." And he closed the book and gave it again to the minister, and sat down. And the eyes of all them were in the synagogue were fastened on him. He began to say, "This is the day, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your ears."
So he was reading Isaiah 61, I believe. He said, "What, I'm come to bring good tidings and gifts to the people." That's basically teaching. So you would think these Christians, especially your family, if they hear that you're doing this, they would have think you have to. But no, they'll think it's strange.
Go out there.
I mean, you're doing exactly what the Lord did. You got the truth, and you're going down to teach. You would think that this would be a highly sought after profession, but the Lord don't want it. I mean, it is on the wicked side. You got niggas that say, I need to make some money. I'm good at speaking. I'm good at tricking people. I'm smooth with my lips. I should be a pastor. They don't give a damn about the word. They don't give a damn about teaching the truth. They just trying to outdo the next guy who has his gimmick. I see he came down from the ceiling with smoke. I need to fly, jump out of a plane with a parachute. That's how they think. How they gonna outdo the next one just to flash it. Now you got them people just playing soccer in the damn church.
Falling all out loud, like you got a crossbow.
Right. Healing the people. They trying to really slap those people. You know what I'm saying?
See the nigga swinging his jacket and the whole crowd is faking.
Yeah. But you see, that's what they try to do. They try to go above and beyond. I'm telling you, somebody gonna jump on a plane with a parachute. They gonna die. Well, something gonna happen. They gonna try to outdo the thing. It's all a hustle.
Well, something similar to happen. I think it might have been like an African priest. He like buried himself. He ended up dying. He buried himself, trying to raise from the dead, and he ended up dying and suffocating.
The scripture said, "Thou shalt not tell the fools, tell the boy he paid the price, because he should pay the mission." Bankroll.
Yeah, precept. This is Matthew 9, starting at 36th verse. But when he saw, talking about Yahweh Shai, when he saw the multitude, he was moved with compassion on them, because they fainted and were scattered abroad as the sheep having no shepherd. Then he said unto his disciples, The harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord, the harvest, that he would select it, that he will send forth laborers into his harvest.
So the harvest, which is the people, right? So when they are white, they are white. So if the laborers are people, pray the Lord send more. This is a good thing, you know. Even Moses said, when he heard that you had guys basically prophesying, one of his men was like, "Moses forbid them." He said, "Forbid them." He said, "I wish all of Israel would prophesy." Right? Because, and that's a good attitude to have. That's more dealing with selflessness. Like, man, I wish everybody had the gift. Right? And that's why you got some guys out there who don't like the idea of everybody getting basically in the kingdom. They got more hate for Jake than you think. They want you to be going for good. They're like, "No, nigga, you dead, you going for good." "No, man, he gonna come back in the kingdom, he gonna get his head right." "What? I ain't with that." "Man, you got more hate. Man, you got more hate than the fucking Esau, man."
Yeah, like a lot of these Christians, they just want him something. Like, why the fuck you want a place like that to exist?
Yeah, everlasting torment.
Yeah, like,
gone back from the commandment of his lips. I have esteemed the words of his mouth more than my necessary food. But neither have I gone back from the commandment of his lips. I have esteemed the words of his mouth more than my necessary food.
Because, yeah, and that's exactly what the Lord said. Labor not for the because that's all temporary. You're gonna get hungry again. Right? So you always gonna be seeking more food. But this word is true for what you got. It's more valuable than it is. Like Joe said, I see this word. So we pray the Lord for our daily bread. It's on the physical and spiritual. We're gonna be daily bread. On a daily increase, and you want to have that enough, but you know that it's more important. This is important. This word increasing in the spiritual, over the physical. You know, so if you can get overweight, and you have overweight people that started there. Eventually, they ask you to get weight, and they're gonna die, right? They can't die. You see, they can get illness, HIV, all of that, and they won't. Because you actually got people right now who like in their 50s and their 60s. And they really can't give any beneficial advice at all to you niggas. So it's just really like, so in your 60 something years, you can't give the people nothing. You can't really give any advice at all. And I've actually asked Jake on the job. And I'd say if there's anything you can give advice to young people, pull yourself. They really can't say. Work hard. That's about it.
Better laws of the land.
Yeah, go to school. Get an education. Which we know in fucking university, all type of wickedness, sex orgies, especially if Jake gets into these fraternities and sororities, especially you black people, and into these damn sororities, experimenting with other women. Okay, putting tattoos and branding marks on your bodies and getting drunk, doing drugs. I mean, pretty much nothing good can come out of that university.
A lot of people get pointed that direction.
Yeah. So if you say get an education and all that, I would then say, okay, so what's the real information I need to get? Something, you know, say what you're saying, this and that. You better give something. I've met Jake that can't tell you. I'm like, so you just only living for your own benefit, 100%. You can't even give any beneficial advice to someone else. And you 60 something plus, you know, about to retire. So that's
First Timothy chapter 6 and verse 12. And the reason it says, fight the good fight of faith, lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses.
How you get paid? You're gonna get paid to keep it. Exactly. I'm actually just doing what we're supposed to do, believe it or not. But consider it unprofitable, I'm sorry. Right? So all that is to keep it, huh? So you can't walk around, all right, now the Lord died to get me. You're supposed to do that. So what? But he will give it to you. He will bless you. So let's show you this. Take joy in it. Whatever job you do, you gotta find a way to take joy in it, especially something like that. Because otherwise, you do it without even worrying about it. And that's basically it. You're gonna get paid in the king. That's how we proceed. And the Lord still bless you.
Yeah,
happening, tornadoes, hurricanes, all that. The Bible explains it, but can you explain?
You know what? There's no explanation for that.
It is. Can I show you?
There's no explanation. No,
it's no problem. I want to show you that.
Because y'all family.
We're waiting for the Uber.
Okay, so while you're waiting, I can tell you.
That's good. You know what? God bless every one of you and your own family.
He's Puerto Rican too.
Ooh, Puerto Rican? And the other
thing. No, I will explain your poquito.
I told you Puerto Rican, you don't speak Spanish.
Hey man, that's the way it goes.
You grew up here in San Luis?
No, New York.
New York? I'm from New York. Oh, I live in New York.
Oh, you still live there?
I've been living in New York for 53 years.
Oh, okay.
But I'm Puerto Rican.
Right.
Well, Puerto Rico,
I had something. Oh no, somebody got it. You got a preset?
Yeah, I got whatever.
All right. This is Acts chapter 2, and I'll start at verse 36. It'll be about 5 verses. And it reads, therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that the Most High have made the same Jehoshaphat, whom ye have crucified. This is Peter talking to the other Jews, whom ye have crucified, both Lord and Hamashiach. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Hamashiach, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promises unto you and to your children and to all that are far off, even as many as the Lord our power shall call. And with many other words did he testify and exalt, saying, save yourselves from this untoward generation. Then they that gladly received his words were baptized, and the same day there were added unto them about 3,000 souls. So by doing the work, we increase the kingdom of the Most High.
That's why I mentioned going to read that prayer for the wedding. That's what it's all about.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he said that my house may be full.
Right.
That's really what he's looking down. You know, he ain't looking down like I said, oh, Mayweather just won another one. You know what I'm saying? Oh, this guy just hit a new record for backflips. Oh, they got new developments. I'm more concerned about my word being. Because the word gets preached, your souls are converted, which leads to the kingdom. That's his desire, right? To get a kingdom that isn't nice to keep. Okay? But our people rather could prolong it. I say, okay, well, I'm going to stay sleepy because I don't want that to happen. But guess what? Whether you choose it or not, you ain't taken away the fact that it's going to happen. It's going to happen. And that's the reality people got to accept, especially in Christians. The Lord is going to come in your lifetime. Unless you push your age, 89 years old, going on 90 right now, you're going to see the Lord in real life. And then again, then you still may see the Lord. Well, my grandkids, I want to see them grow up. They going to see the Lord in their lifetime.
They got some creep. They calling me to come back to the streets and sign me. They got some creep. I'm going to talk without my Hebrew Israelites.
I used to read like Atlanta.
It was neither herb nor mollifying plaster that restored him to health, but thy word, O Lord. Verse 11. It said, when they were pricked that they should remember thy word, and were quickly saved, they not fall into deep forgetfulness. Then it's like they might be continually mindful. Thy goodness. It was neither herb nor mollifying plaster that restored him to health, but thy word. Oh,
it
says, there's not herb nor mollifying plaster that restored them to health, but thy word, the Lord.
That's right, so not herb that restored, not herb, anything like that. And that's why the scripture says that the Most High cometh healing with Hezekiah. He was actually, he was going back and forth. So he was righteous. Went off, repented, observed him. He actually extended his life 15 years. See, the Lord did create physicians in that craft, they just skill in that craft. So it's not a useless tactic. I mean, it's not a useless profession. It's actually good. I always say if I could start over, I would go right into the herbal business. Because I think being a healer is awesome. But you know, we all basically deal with it. But I would have dived straight into it, hit the books, all that. Like, I would have flew people over here in protest and all of this. Just so I can learn as much as I could about the human body and what plants do. That's all you need. Yeah. If you know everything about the human body, basically inside and out, all you need to know is the effect that certain plants have on you. It's like you don't need nothing else. You don't need nothing else. A book, like an encyclopedia, give you a description, put the stuff together, make it happen. It's like, and that's my opinion. But some brothers out there, like I said, you learn over time. So that brother got a lot of information. Bring it out. But what's better than that? So, Lord can extinct them. It's the Lord that they find out that you want to help you, get you back to help. It's the Lord. His name. But you got as much they believe in deliverance itself. The greatest, the ultimate specialist or whatever is always going to be there. It's always going to be the heavenly Father. You got people in that tree. Draw it real, but not the people. Right? They can draw realistic people, make it look real. And they may be like, damn, that one. It's the Christ of the Creator of the world. So, you know, he gave men the power to take glory, to take joy in his pain. That's why you love pain. Little joy that comes with pain. He's got five problems. And he's really into it. That's because the Heavenly Father created that craft to take joy in it. He created animals. He loved animals better than that. That's the Father created them. He's supposed to take joy in it. And then you got some people who take that and either worship it as a god, or they believe that this is all I need to perform. The Heavenly Father is the ultimate craftsman. He's the ultimate healer. He literally turned a pond that was full of bitterness into clean water for our people to drink. Can't no herb specially do that. So the Lord comes with it. So he goes his word.
Yeah, also, you know, these physicians, they're not going to tell you the other half of being healed, which is ceasing from sin, praying to the Heavenly Father. Because the scriptures also tell you that's the nature of how the physician is supposed to go about healing, because the Lord is the one who ultimately going to deliver you from that sickness or whatever. You got to cease from sin and pray. Exactly. You know? That, so and those herbs and those things that Lord put here for us to use, they go hand in hand with prayer and ceasing from sin.
Exactly. And that's what the physician did. Because you said ceasing from sin, right? How do they know what they're doing is sin? They got to hear the word of the Lord.
That's right.
So the word of the Lord come and heal. So if you was doing your job, all right, so how did you get in this situation? Man, I don't know, but if you know that Lord is sick, you got to put that out there. And they're supposed to repent and work the little magic they do, and you'll be healed. And ultimately, give glory to the Lord and never do it again. I know the Lord told those who were healed, especially the woman who didn't go, he said, go, and sin no more. Right? And if it happened again, basically, it's glory. You gotta cleanse yourself, only, and then you're gonna put dirt back in. So it's really a word of the Lord that's gonna extend your life.
That's right.
So again, this word, the fact that you can teach the truth, you see the power that it has. It has power and not even a position.
Yeah, and if I can say, if it wasn't for the majority of, which Esau, he has it. On the left hand side, so he knows about certain herbs and stuff. They just mix it up and make it into pills and all this. Watch one of your videos, like you said that. And if it wasn't for like Esau's so-called high blood pressure medicine, a lot of you Israelites would be dead, man. Like for real. Like goddamn pacemakers and all that.
Your heart is a natural pacemaker.
That's right. And like some of the simplest, like a diet, because Israel loves salt, because the Most High compares Israel to what? Salt. Well, you put salt in the earth. Right? But too much goddamn salt can kill you. Alright? Especially when you eat especially when you eat unclean foods on top of that. first episode was him was talking about the Lord was a dark skinned man. Electricity bill go up. All right. Right. And then, not only that, like on Thanksgiving, it's Thanksgiving coming up after Halloween. All this food that they buy, all right, this is gonna get thrown away. Okay. Ain't nobody gonna eat all this shit. Like as far as I remember, my family, they never ate all the Thanksgiving food. Never. Ever. It was all wasted food. Well, holiday was made to kill you.
Yeah, you're supposed to have through the word of the Lord, right? They also teach you morals and principles. You got people now who broke, can't afford nothing, don't like the baby mama, don't nothing. But they say, well, at least I got my kids. So you did that to prove what? You love them? Guess what? Anything I gotta do is give them a speech. Call me on the head, I'm gonna propose on your back, put on the table.
Right.
That's enough right there. They wanna talk about some present, just slap them on the shoulder. But you would be like, I am providing. I do love you. If I use the present, make it holiday for them. And when they would get all upset, so what? They'll be over to you. Right. But that's injecting a servant to their kids. Everything go back to the scriptures. Like I told my parents and that whole father day, mother day family. My dad got mad at me. He got on. I told him, I said, yeah, just say if I don't talk to you damn near a whole year, but I call you just one day just to say that. Would you prefer that or would you prefer me to actually just be yourself? He was like the latter. I was like, all right, so I don't need a day out of the year to show my appreciation to you. The scripture says, honor my parents. Exactly. I do that every day. I said, so you don't need me to do that. Here it is, my brother is a dick. They fight all year, and then this one day he said, like, what matters more to you? That shit? Or if he was actually stop acting like this right there? So the thing is, same thing. So they got the hint, they never said nothing. I know they still look for it during that day. I don't give it to you. You should notice that. You got the scriptures, man. The scriptures tell you. You see, you parents, you would even want your kids to follow you. But if you had the understanding of the scripture, then you can teach that to your children. Look, you're supposed to honor people. I'm your parent. So don't come to me with this, you know, you buy me this, and that. You know what I'm saying? So everything boils to the scripture to keep order, and that's what really shows love.
That's right.
I told you to have some, but you said you had some.
You want to get yours first, so it's
yours. Yeah, hold on. Salakia. This is Psalms 119 and verse starting at verse 9. It said, wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? Right? It's asking the question. It says, by taking heed thereto according to thy word. So you're supposed to listen, you know, take heed to the scriptures. Right? With my whole heart have I sought thee. Oh, let me not wander from thy commandments. Right? It says, thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. So you taking heed to these commandments, you know, you'll clean your way and repent, you know, Yahweh Bashem Yahushai heal you, and you know, you become a better person.
orders. So knowing how precious that is, do you feel ashamed or embarrassed to teach them? Even more like, you need to be around people, not afraid. I don't like to be around even friends in the world. I have to respect myself, separate myself from this anymore. Because they still want to basically put the rule over their own. Talking, watching this movie, and then they'll be like, acknowledging Trinity as whatever, right? The other word. And then you say, yeah, they look at you like, oh man, like that. Like, acknowledge you. Right. But that's annoying after a while. And you're like, well, y'all really still gonna believe that thing, even though it's a lie? I gotta separate myself. And then, not for any type of way. You don't have to come up hostile or anything. Just say what that means. That's certain. I believe the scriptures say. They gonna hate it. The Lord already said they not hate you, they hate me. Yeah. And Yahweh Shah is the epitome of righteousness and truth. So when you speak truth, you're speaking nothing. They got a problem with him, not you. But he says, you know, the world will always know. Because in the blink of an eye, you can change your doctrine. Say, no, I ain't with that Hebrew Israelite stuff no more. Then your family loves you now. The world loves you now. Your woman loves you now. So is it really you that they hate? No, it's what you stand for. Because if you do a complete 180, you back into the race. As long as you stand for the truth, it's a problem. And guess what? I'm glad to be on this side.
Yes.
Y'all don't stand for none of the principles or none of the backstab each other. Y'all do what y'all think is right. Y'all hold a hard time.
All in the manner of what you need to do to prove you say.
Like Jake. Now let's say like you and your woman broke up. You know, that some of your so-called boys, they're trying to talk to your woman. Okay? A lot of our women just straight up wicked. She try to like throw it at them, and then this nigga not having integrity, he'll catch him. You know, oh, well, she came on speed. Like, nigga, you ain't supposed to do that. You know? Say that's still considered adultery, especially if your brother's in the truth.
Yeah, you guys are supposed to live off some type of code, you know? The code is supposed to be. Even in the Italians, they got a cold mafia, they got a cold, right? If there's certain things they don't tolerate, one of them is a notion. Play about that. It's like that movie, Not even that one. Travolta. He's playing John Gotti. One of his men had to go away for a bit. And then he told his boy, he said, all right, listen, you deliver money to his wife's house, make sure she gets this money each week or something. But he told him not to go alone. And then one week, the next week, he pulled him to the side. He said, what the heck? Take me to money to the girls, and I took the money to the wife's house. He said, what did I tell you? Didn't I say to bring your cousin? He's like, yeah, but he was busy. He said, you never go to another man's wife's room without anybody else. Because they don't play that. Because what can that look like? You come back and you like, when he was here by himself, if you had to go with some type of witness. And they didn't play about that. He's like, no, you don't show me that. Even at the casino, De Niro, everything was going through. What was happening was eventually, committed adultery. Pesci slept with the girl that Darryl was with, and they was like, oh, so now you gotta go. See, they live some type of code, even though they're wicked as all that. Right? But you Jakes out there, y'all don't live off no code. The code you're supposed to live by is the scripture. Of this come healing, order, prosperity, it all comes right here, man. Its value isn't acknowledged until shit goes south. You know what I'm saying? Shit gotta go south for people to realize how precious it is. be in the snares for you to realize. Now you're in a position where it can't be reversed. You know, now you got disease or something. Anything where it can't be reversed, and you're just sitting there like, I should just listen to the word. That's why you got to be thankful. And there's times where you can't get out of it. Thank the Lord like that. The Lord's heard. And some people get into situations because they don't listen. And they're in a situation, wherever it is, it can't be reversed. A situation you don't want to be. But had you just listened to the verse, and yeah, you may, it may seem like you're born. More like you're missing out, you know, on your life is saved.
Yeah. Like the constant, like basically, like if it's like a woman that you deal with on the job or whatever, or a woman got a man who's feeling you, they say this is the best you can go to another job. And I took that advice.
Because every day you see her, she was going to try to correct some kind of issue or some shit.
Yeah.
Because I don't get why women do that. When they like you, they'll do shit that ain't fucking funny. You know, and it pisses you off and they think that's hilarious.
Right. That's that nigga woman shit. Like, the nigga woman, she think that her trying to usurp authority over you is funny. This shit ain't funny. And then look, and then you start getting their ass, they don't know how to submit themselves. So they just keep going further. You know? You're like, okay, this not cute. I can
cut that bitch off. This is Luke chapter 14 and verse 23. And the reason it says, and the Lord, verse 21, and it says, so that servant came and shewed his Lord these things. Then the master of the house began being angry, said to his servant, go out quickly unto the streets and the lanes of the city, and bring hither the poor, and the maimed, and the halt, and the blind. And the servant said, Lord, it is done as thou hast commanded, yet there is room. And the Lord said unto the servant, go unto the highways and hedges, compel them to come in, that my house may be filled. You know, and that's going into, you know, the bending into the marriage. You know, because at the end of the day, that is what the Lord set us to do. That's our job to do. Because we are many shepherds, you know. And Yahweh Shai is the ultimate shepherd. Okay, what does a shepherd do? He leads the sheep back into the flock, or he leads a stray sheep back into the fold. That is our job. We got to be enthusiastic about doing this work because, hey, we storing our treasures within heaven. Because at the end of the day, this society, you get a paycheck, you spend it on bills and all the other stuff, you know, but the stuff we getting paid for within the heavens is eternal.
That's what
you get.
This is what you get the Most High is really concerned about. You ask these people, what's the will of the Lord? The Lord wants us as a country to develop, do this, and they don't give a fuck about none of that. They don't want this country to develop or do nothing. He wants his wedding, he wants to have his wedding filled with guests for his son. That's his will. His will is to bring his son back and set up the kingdom of heaven. His will is not for this society to go on forever. It's not what he wants. It's not what he wants. You don't know the will of the Lord, but they'll claim it. Everything resolves around your heart and chakra. Like I always mentioned, the self resolves around. You got BC and AD, before the Lord, and then Illumini, the year of our Lord. Because the moment he came, the clock started. And that's why when he said, I behold, I come quickly. So every year is a year of our Lord. We are in approximately year 22, the year of our Lord. So he's going to come back. We on his clock. I don't give a damn about what the hell he said, well, I'm coming back. So that's his way. Don't give a damn about what the hell you want to do or what you wish you want to do, you know? He don't want this country to bounce back. He don't want none of that. So you think in worldly, you're supposed to be thinking spiritual. You're supposed to be thinking like everything that's happening is doing what you want. Like I was trying to tell the amigos, the reason it's going down there and down south is because y'all a bunch of poor Catholics. Like Apostle Horace said it. He said, Lord, jack them up, and they all Roman Catholics, man. They all Roman Catholics. And there you go. He, what he said? Roman Catholic. And you lucky you happen to be here and down there, you better count that a blessing. You better not go down there at a minute. But that's what happened. You're getting jacked up, and you don't even know why. So, you don't even pray to anyone.
Catholics, they say Mother Mary.
See, that's
so that's the Queen of Heaven.
It's going way the hell off. See, that's Queen of Heaven.
You know, yeah, a lot of them, like, was Jake Period is a damn natural mom's but, man, like, if you're under that doctrine, man, you just, you know, my madre. You know? That's not the way to be. Scripture says, honor your father, you know?
Right.
And then father's first day, you know?
Meditate on it. That's how it is with the scripture, the law. If you read a law, I don't know why it said that. Go do some research. Esau don't do it. So we did a research and study with us that makes these fishes go understand that they have a purpose. Hopefully they shouldn't be putting that in our mind. And they'll study the hurts and frequency. So they go deep. So you're supposed to do it. This is you're supposed to mock at it. Well, a lot of them mock at it because they don't understand.
Yeah, hey, but that's the thing. You should want to see, like, you should be humble enough to, like, to dig deep. I remember you saying something about, like, if you're like a fighter, you gotta be humble. Man, you can't think, yeah, I got it all figured out. Can't nobody beat me. Matter of fact, I ain't even got a train. Look in the ring, get your ass knocked out.
It happens all the time. Knowledge probably does. It's looking twice.
Right.
See, you don't trust me. That's Iron Mike. That's soft and feminine.
Man, he always had that damn
voice. Yeah, he always did.
Remember he did a song? Super of Flores. You read that song? Read that again. Ephesians 5 and 26. You got the drum,
this is Jeremiah chapter 15 and verse 15. And it reads, O Lord, thou knowest, remember me and visit me and revenge me of my persecutors. Take me not away in thy long suffering,
Know that for thy sake I have suffered rebuke. Thy words were found, and I did eat them. And thy word was unto me the joy and rejoicing of my heart. For I am called by thy name, O Lord, Yahweh of hosts.
Right, so he said, well, don't treat me like these. I'm different. When I hear your words, it brings me joy. I take joy reading your law. Right? Because that's what brings life to you. This generation now, they don't basically have it. So you already know there's no future. Because they don't even have the correct words to give to counsel people. Like, little do they know, I think about it all the time. If you just wanted to build a city, right? First thing you gotta do, somebody asks, okay, what's the first thing you do? First thing you do is you give people, you know the words of the Lord, establish the word. You gotta know the word of the Lord first. Versus somebody else who would say,
what's the bread you said? See the man.
But that's it.
You talking to you.
Teach a man how to fish, something like that. Oh, yeah. But give somebody some food or whatever, but if you show them how to do it, it'll last.
Yeah. I don't know how I quite said it.
I know how you said it. You said, if you give a man a fish, you only fed him for the day. But if you teach a man how to fish, you fed him all the time.
Yeah, I think we were talking about trades in the hands. So, you know, just like you, Brother Down was going into universities and schools, that's good for a certain specific life that you want for yourself.
Yeah.
But like young men, I try to tell them, if you got a chance, then you learn a trade. You put a skill in your hand, you know, and in that way you can feed yourself for the rest of your life. Exactly. You know?
See, that's knowledge. I always value, like even with jobs, right? Growing up, I always valued experience over the so-called credentials, paper, I graduated from here and all that. Because I'm gonna be truthful, a lot of these jobs, they don't even give a shit about that. They honestly just want to know, can you change a tire? Can you do this? Can you? Yeah, I can do that. You got a job. Because 9 times out of 10, you ain't doing all of that anyway. And if you know how to do something, you can be taught to do the rest.
Yeah. Right.
Right. Now, years ago, you had to have all those credentials and stuff like that. But I always felt like, man, if I can just go in there saying, yeah, I know how to do this, this, and that, that'll take you further than somebody who say, well, I was in school. If I go pick up, do you have the experience? You got a lot of people who think, especially women, they're going to get that wake-up call, that damn diploma, master's, whatever, they can keep you warm at night. You should have the knowledge, wisdom it takes to be a virtuous woman.
Right.
Because through that, you can get a right husband. Through that, you can be blessed with a heavenly father. And that, you can get all things. And then from that, you can go on to learn such and such. But you got witness, hey, we got master's degrees, and they can't hold water.
Experience the best teacher, like the brother said.
Yeah. Even close enough, they don't even know they're getting it from the scripture. Yeah, experience the best teacher. Guess what? That's in the scripture. See?
This is the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 19. The reason it says, for the wisdom of this world is foolishness with Yahweh. For it is written, he taketh the wise in their own craftiness. And again, the Lord knoweth the thoughts of the wise, that they are vain.
Everything that you ever thought of goes back to the scriptures, like even like the keto diet. All right, I think Daniel was on what? The keto diet, he was just eating the pulse. And I don't even think he even had bread. I think he was eating just raw vegetables and all that. You know, because he didn't want to like partake of Nebuchadnezzar's meat and his bread, you know, and his wine. And he went a certain time period without drinking, too. Which that's also beneficial for your body. Because alcohol actually lowers your immune system while you're drunk.
Spiritual stuff like that.
Yeah, they too.
And, you know, and the point where it says, hey, that this world's wisdom is foolishness to the power. You know, hey, man, no matter what degree that you got, you know, like your doctorate, your master's, your PhD, man, they knowledge don't compare to what comes out of this. Because this is living waters right here, as Yahweh Shah spoke. And what are the living waters? Wisdom and knowledge and understanding of the scriptures, man. Man, these damn devils, man, wish they could understand the scriptures like we can.
Right.
When they come to us, the only thing they can bring up is John 3:16, and what about the did you get it with the Galatians, you know? Hey, man. These devils, man, they don't know nothing, man. The true people that's supposed to teach these scriptures are the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, so the Hebrew Israelites, man.